opportunity to quit everything. Because you're not going to, A, you're going to be going insane, but you're not going to have to be at work while you go insane for most of you, except for those of you who do have to go to work. And B, you can't get any more. I mean, maybe you get six, Jewel, but like for people, so I've gotten a lot of messages, not a lot, but about six or seven from people who are drug users and some drug people who are themselves like drug addicts. And you know, it's funny, I was thinking about this at the sort of beginning of this crisis when I was like, damn, when I was a junkie, like this would be the scariest fucking thing in the world for me. Because you're like, nope, man, he's not going to be there. Or maybe he'll get COVID. Or maybe, you know, I'm sure that the supply lines, especially if they close the borders, which is, you know, on its way. States, I think is going to happen. You're freaked out because you know you won't be able to get it, and like I don't even know. I mean, I have no idea if like detoxes and all those sort of things are open. I know the ones I work at are not having me come in, so I don't know what that means. For those of you who are freaking out about having to like maybe stop drinking or maybe stop using dope or speed or something. Don't worry about it, baby. Give me a fucking hit the podcast DMs, and I'll try to connect you with someone where you are, because I know a fucking lot of sober people. Or I can just tell you how a little tips and tricks I have for making withdrawals out so bad. That's the thing. I never freaking get sick because I was basically sick every other day for like 4 years, so it's fine with me. But I just wanted to mention that. Because that has been not frequent, but not infrequent sort of tenor of semester coming in. And I was able to connect some people with some other people, which is, you know, worked out pretty good. Here's the thing. You're going to have to stop shooting snack any time. This is the perfect time to stop doing it. Because you got nothing to do. You know, you're going to be sick anyways. Not with COVID necessarily, but, you know, it'll be fine.
Drugs or get in trouble or girls crying, anything like that. people talking to Italian doctors, and they just keep saying over and over, you have no idea how overwhelmed the hospitals are. You've never seen or
exactly. And we are talking about the public healthcare of Lombardia, of the area around the Alps,
which is the richest part of Italy, right? So.
And they are an excellent treatment, excellent hospital, excellent doctors, top quality machinery, but still, and there is, of course, there's a political debate going right now about the cut that has been done in the last 10 years about the non-Italian healthcare, particularly the cut on beds in hospitals. Right now, the intensive care units are completely overwhelmed, so they are starting to send people sick and people need to be treated in Emilia Romagna, so in Bologna, in Veneto, in Piemonte, the area around Turin, and so on. But in those areas, while not as many people infected as they have near Milan, the numbers are rising, and they are rising very quickly. We had another 1,500 people were being infected yesterday. Today the numbers are around 1,000. We had something like 500 were being hospitalized this morning. Probably there are another 500 who are going to be confirmed tonight. So we are numbers of 1,000 up to 2,000 every day for the last 3 days, and the numbers are really mounting. And again, we are talking that most of these people require treatment, so they cannot stay home, they cannot cure themselves, and 1/10 up to 15% of these people requires intensive care. And a certain percentage of these people is going to die. Okay, so the situation is grim, and the reason behind the lockdown is precisely that. Even a modern and organized and well organized healthcare like the Italian healthcare that I remind your audience is a free healthcare. Okay.
Yeah, I've lived in Italy and I've been to Italian hospitals and no one even dreamed of making me pay. I was utterly stunned when that happened. I had to go to hospitals and money didn't come up and that just seemed unnatural.
Okay, and so it is you get an excellent treatment, but still it's getting overwhelmed by the sheer number of people that need to be treated.
I should mention in passing too that the staff also were charitable about the fact that I didn't speak Italian and that too might be different here. So altogether, it was a pretty idyllic experience. And yes, if that system is overwhelmed, that's very bad when you try to apply the lesson to the U.S.
Well, and I mean, just think about hospitals that always have to make budget decisions. How many ventilators are they going to have in each hospital? How many breathing tubes? Like, how many they're going to have to budget based on what they would expect in normal, or let's say, you know, not normal circumstances, but not something like a pandemic like this. I mean, you can't just keep in a hospital tons of beds and ventilators and all this expensive equipment. I mean, you can, but you're not going to. Assuming one day in the next 50 years there's going to be a pandemic, right? So the shortage is, it's completely understandable in a place like that. And then here, of course, everything is on the profit motive.
Yeah, I mean, we look at it from the market's perspective. Yeah. The market would be saying, are you insane? That, you know, it's like running a timeshare in a vacation condo. It's only going to get occupied for maybe a month in the next 40 years.
Yeah.
That's not
going to
pay.
No, and I'll be straightforward with you guys, but we're going to talk about that a bit more later. I have no idea how the U.S. could cope with anything like that. I'll be completely honest, and today I heard about Ricciardi,
sort of the math on this and was predicting 6 to 8 million. We're going to catch it by, we're going to have it by, I don't know, I think it was like, you know, mid-late, by mid-May or something. That the exponential numbers are such that that's where it was going. I mean, you had a graph and everything. It's pretty frightening. That's what kind of really slapped.
Your audience to understand. When people think about this kind of because we are being told that cash is dirty and cash can be contaminated, so we're going to use credit cards or any kind of piece of plastic as much as possible. And then we're going to wash the pieces of plastic when we are home. So you become really obsessive.
Sneeringly describes the square kilometer.
right now, because of course everybody has his own opinion about the right management. And so right now the narrative goes that at the beginning everybody was just like downplaying the danger. There were particularly that has been people, politicians will say, no, it's a big, it's not a huge, huge problem. Milan cannot shut down because it's the economic engine of Italy. And then, of course, the casualties have got to pile up. And some of these politicians have been infected. It's interesting because this is a virus that is not sparing the rich and the powerful,
yes.
Unlike other type of epidemics. This is a equal opportunity virus.
Well, not entirely, because of all of us, I think I'm the only one here in the over 60 range, have the dubious health range. So I don't know. It's benign.
It infects people. I guess it discriminates by age, but it doesn't discriminate by by class just yet. Because actually, a lot of rich, powerful people are getting it. I mean, the CPAC conference, which is this big, notorious conservative annual Washington, D.C. conference of the right wing of the conservative movement. Trump kind of comes out of it, Breitbart and stuff. They were there, I think, talking about how the whole coronavirus was either a yellow peril plot or invented by liberals and the fake media, and Trump was ahead. And now it turns out there are some people infected. They're only finding out now, and I mean, there's a chance Trump may have it. I don't know. He was tested.
Well, that's what Steve Olin. I don't know. I've heard people say you should get rid of the rumors.
It's what? I mean, what?
Excuse me.
A lot of the people who have been told, they were asymptomatic, they had no symptoms. themselves or to clean surfaces. So every alcohol, you know, the kind of alcohol, not the alcohol you drink, the kind of alcohol,
like rubbing
or on it, that you're going to rub, but it's going to disappear, okay? And masks are going to disappear, gloves are going to disappear. This is a problem we already had.
You know, that's, can I stop you there? Because there's one interesting thing. Wouldn't gloves be effective? Because I haven't heard much about gloves.
Gloves are effective. At the moment, much, because for, of course, as most of the people who has small bars, small restaurants, they are also much easier. Yeah. They have this kind of thing. They are not making any money.
No, I have okay. That's a kind of overseas Chinese first or second generation entrepreneurship. That's what you do. It gets you in at the low end, and then you can take it up from there. But yeah, that I remember a famous case that was initially used to provoke anti-Chinese hysteria, but it didn't work out that way at all. If I recall, there was a woman from China who went to Paris, flew to Paris, and boasted about having beaten the body temperature detector thing by taking some kind of pill, and therefore having been allowed to travel to Paris. And other Chinese internet users were so angry that they tracked her down and made her quarantine herself.
Wow. Yeah. Yes, yes, and we had the cases of people coming back from China here in Italy that were really, I mean, there was a lot of self-control by the Chinese community. We were told that other members of the Chinese community, you're right now, you need to put yourself in quarantine. And by the way, now we know, we have evidence that the virus was already circulating in Italy. January, so very early on, and the suspicion is that the virus actually came from one story, but that does not be completely confirmed. The virus came from Germany, from a German businessman who had dealings with China, went to China, got infected, came here, and but we will never know. It's just an hypothesis.
Yeah, that's the thing. I was looking at the number of civilian flights per day. I forget the exact number of flights, but I know that I was shocked to find that it's doubled just since, I think, 2005. And especially with a virus like this that seems to be remarkable for the slow development of its symptoms, how can you close borders against something like
that? No, you can't. You can't. You can't. It's impossible. This is the reason why, guys, there is no alternative to a robust healthcare infrastructure. No modern state can live in a globalized world without one. Okay.
Yeah, another prediction, as firmly as you made that one, America will not learn. America
yes.
will not.
That I totally agree with. Yes. This is going to be a catastrophe, and nothing will be learned. I mean, this is if there is a lesson to be learned of the last 20 years or so, that no lesson is ever learned anymore, in part because no one ever pays. And the only way you pay is if you're, you know, maybe you didn't reach the very pinnacle of whatever power and money
yes.
that you felt was owed to you, but you and everybody who supports you and lives through you is going to keep pushing for that until you get it. Like, no one pays.
Well, Hillary
is my exact
example of that. I mean, she is actually feeling... making it very clear that she feels angry and hurt because she is not the president of the United States, and lashing out because of that. It's astonishing.
Yeah.
But yes, something about relative deprivation there, you want to learn it. But in the meantime, yeah, there's no penalty short of not being president of the U.S.
Mm-hmm. And, and getting back to something else that Ibole just was saying when I asked about
I want to give you some more
yes.
food for thought.
Yes.
The first thing is, one thing that a lot of people, because it's not being discussed in, you know, in popular media, but one thing, because I have a discussion with someone who is deeply involved with this in Italy, and she told me that one of the
the numbers of those killed, but in terms of the world population, are very small.
Yes, exactly. But what? But this is not actually. It's not a reason to feel relieved, to feel complacent, because this means there is something that we don't understand in the way how the virus spread. And there are several questions that right now the scientists cannot really answer. The numbers.
Yeah. said, no, we right now we can't test here. I think it actually was at Whiteview Hospital. We can't test here, but you know what we can do is we're still waiting for instructions from the governor, who's waiting for instructions from the Trump administration.
Southern hemisphere is very low.
Yeah.
Okay. So, in order to calm down the riot, there have been some negotiations going on between the authorities and the inmates, and now the situation seems to be calming down. But it's you get the sense that in a situation like this, every problem can become exponentially more acute, yes, more severe,
right,
if
right.
It's controlled.
And
not
you can't predict it.
Because it's very important at the moment. Sorry.
It is. No, it is.
This is how you
and
it
you know,
limit, yeah.
The way it happens
here. We found it.
Yeah. Look, there's a lot of this, and I just think, you know, things went so right-wing in this country, and then the liberal Democrats normalized it, and then they keep moving, and the other guy keeps moving the ball right. And it's just things people just sort of accept here. I mean, this is going a little off topic, and I'll get back, but just real quickly on that. You know, Mayor Bloomberg, who ran as a Democrat, he used prison, which is basically slave labor, to make it make sense in the hour. This is the richest guy, the ninth richest guy in America, used prison labor to run his phone banks for his campaign. This condo that he made it, oh yeah. You know, Hillary Clinton, in her book, her first book that came out in the late 90s, that was her book to kind of establish her political persona, bragged about how they had black prison labor in the governor's mansion in Arkansas. She had built it, and when they started acting up, they were sent back to the prison. So they had a choice of doing working for. I mean, it's so insane. And the liberals read this, and it didn't. You have to point out to people how crazy it is, and they say, "Oh yeah, yeah, that is kind of crazy." But that's how screwed up things are in this country. John is in a particularly vulnerable situation. He's still traveling around, and here in America, in the shittiest country in the world, he's sick in, potentially. I mean, hopefully.
Oh, thanks, Uncle Jack. That's really kind of you. I just got a little new donation. Thank you so much. Let me know. I'm going to have a lot of time to paint. Let me know what I can send or bring to you. Folks who are looking at them, sorry, I've been kind of like lost in working on this. People who are film folk will recognize this as a image from Battleship Potemkin movie, one of the classic cinema. Well, it's a classic cinema edited by Sergei Eisenstein.
I'm in that weird position of a scared person who probably actually has something to be scared about.
I mean, I'll be honest, I am too, because as you pointed, you know, this is a true Logan's Run type tease. I mean, it's not just, there are grades of who's more vulnerable, but nevertheless, I'm over 50, and you could be healthy, but you're over 50, it's still a car that's been out there on the streets for over 50 years, and the way that this bug works, and we still don't, this is one of the scariest things too, and I'm getting this from you as well, anybody. What's also frightening is you don't really know yet everything about it, because it keeps acting in way, you know, when you think you kind of have a handle on it, then you see other data coming in, and it doesn't quite work that way. It can be a lot worse than we think. Sometimes it can be less worse than we think. Is that right?
Yes, exactly. No, we don't. It could happen. It arrives to the U.S. and then it gets them down for some reason, and it turns out that the hotspot in Wuhan or in Italy were just the result of some special circumstances. Or, and I personally believe in the second option much more. Or simply, you will replicate everywhere what happened here, but on a completely different scale. And again, this World Health Organization representative in Italy was positive about this second option. The idea that other countries are going to experience what happened.
Alright, this has got to dry us a little bit before I add the next layer.
More than what is happening right now in Korea, just on a different scale and only.
Really happy with everything else is setting. I might try to add some hairline. But I will definitely make that pop a little bit. Yeah?
Unknowns that are virus. So they are at the moment are making some physical studies to try to understand exactly who is going to be more hit by the virus, what are the types of quarantine or the types of operation that needs to be done to stop the disease and so on. So this is a big advantage, okay? You are and I think
in spite of our totally screwed up system and leadership and so on, there will be scientists and doctors. But there are doctors and hospitals, and there are other people who are not part of this structure who
it's all that need.